What's up guys, welcome to our channel Etechniz. In this video we will talk about how to fix Wi-Fi connected but no internet access on Windows 10. We will show you the method and the step you have to use to fix this problem, so stay tuned and watch the complete video. Method 1. Restore point. In this method you have to restore your Windows 10 PC to the backdate. As I have read on a lot of tech forum that restore point helped them to fix the problem, because restore point usually restore your Windows 10 PC to the backdate when your PC configuration was working perfectly fine. So restoring can help you to fix your problem. For to restore your Windows 10 PC, you have to click in this search box and type RSTRUI. You'll see run command, click on open, click choose a different restore point and click next. Check this box, show more restore points, and you'll see all the restore point in here. Select the date when your Windows 10 PC was working perfectly fine for the Wi-Fi connection, and click on scan for affected programs. Once you'll click on it, you'll see a list of information in here. The first one says program and driver that will be deleted. So these are the programs that gonna be deleted from our PC, and these are the programs and drivers that might be restored. Click on close if you are satisfied with the result. Select your restore point, click on next, and restore your Windows 10 PC to the backdate. Method 2. Check network status. In this method, we have to perform two steps. The first step is a ping test. Here you have to do some things. For that, you have to open command prompt, type in search, cmg, select run as administrator. Click on yes, and in here you have to type ipconfig and press enter. Once you'll have a default gateway IP address, then you have to ping that IP address to make sure your computer is connected to your router properly or not. So type ping space 10.0.2.2 and press enter. You'll see a result in here. As you can see, there is no loss in here, 0% loss. So my computer is connected to my router and it's replying properly. Afterwards, you have to type ping space any website like www.google.com and press enter. You'll receive a reply and the timings in here, and there is no loss. As I said, my internet is working fine, that's why there is no loss in the connection. These are the basic steps every administrator, computer administrator expert or company expert used to do before they use any troubleshooting to check the basic thing, the router is connected properly or not, and it receiving the reply from a website properly or not. After this, you have to do a step 2 to check the proxy settings. For to check the proxy setting, there are the two options you have to check. First, click on Windows icon, click on settings, click on network and internet. Here you'll see proxy, and check the proxy information. This option is off or it's on. If you'll see address and port information, remove them and turn it off. And the second thing which you have to check, for that type in here run, click open, type inetcpl.cpl, click OK, click on connections, click on LAN settings, and here you have to check the proxy server setting, is it showing any kind of proxy address or not. If it's showing you any proxy address, then remove that proxy address and set up this option, automatically detect its setting. Check this box, click on OK, apply and OK. And restart your PC and check if that helped you to fix your problem. If you are not able to see any proxy, do not worry about it. We have explained a lot of methods in this video, and I'm pretty sure after trying all of those methods, your problem will get resolved. Method 3. Check network control panel. Here you have to open CMD again, type CMD, run as administrator, click yes. Here you have to type in command ncpa.cpl and you'll see network connection. Do a right click on Ethernet and you'll see properties. Click on Internet Protocol version 4, select properties, and here you have to make sure both of the option selected as automatic. You have to select obtain DNS server address automatically. You have to leave this thing on default setting to obtain DNS server address automatically. Afterward, click OK, close. Method 4. Troubleshoot network. Here you have to click on start, click on settings, scroll it down, click on update and security. On the left hand side, click on troubleshoot, click on additional troubleshooter. You'll see internet connection, click on it, click on run the troubleshooter. It will start some services on your Windows 10 PC and diagnose every information and help you to fix the problem. Method 5. Network driver. For to check the network driver, do a right click on Windows icon or you can type in here device manager. Click on open. Select network adapter, do a double click or you can click on this arrow and you'll see your network adapter. Do a right click, click on update driver and select search automatically for driver. Method 6. Network reset. Here we have to reset the network as there could be a problem on other things as well. So click on start icon, click on settings, network and internet, scroll it down, click on network reset and select reset now. And it will take some time to reset the network and your problem will get resolved. If not, then you can try some advanced troubleshooting commands to fix your problem. For to perform that commands, this is the method 7 to fix your problem using command prompt. For to use all of those commands, you have to click in the search, type CMD, select run as administrator, click yes, and in here you have to type the commands. All of the commands are listed in the description. The first one is netsh space winsock reset. And press enter, and all of those commands you have to enter in the command prompt and you have to run all of those commands. After running all of the command, click on Windows icon and restart your PC. After you restart, I'm pretty sure your problem will get resolved. So these are the methods you have to try to fix the problem if your Wi-Fi connected but no internet access showing Windows 10. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching. Meet you in the next video.